Is April 6, 2020. I'm going to record a dream I had. It's significant for me because I didn't know what I was going to expect from looking up the meaning of the dream. So how perfect the song in the background playing is Black Butterfly. The darkness that gives way to the dawn, you know, as I'm continuously giving birth to another aspect of myself, and it feels so good inside. My dreams have finally been born. Black butterfly. Butterfly, what a beautiful, perfect song to go along with how I feel right now. So I dreamt that I was in this building again. It felt like a factory, like some type of factory, and I felt like I was saving some people in there, or I was going from place to place, and it felt like I was in a hospital, and maybe it was a hospital, maybe it was a building, because I felt like I was guiding people out of this sewer type looking hospital system. So to me, that makes me feel like I was guiding people out of their sicknesses and their illnesses and the diseases of their bodies and minds and souls. And as I went from one area of the building to the next, I didn't stop until I let everyone out, in different ways though, because not everyone was on the same floor, not everyone was in the same type of settings in rooms from what I can remember. So when I was finally at that point or that place where things were coming to some type of a perfect balance in the dream, all of a sudden this alligator was coming towards me. And when the alligator was coming towards me, I was like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? I was like, does it mean that this is the end of my existence? Because I didn't have any weapons on me. I had no brick, I had no stone, I had no spear, I had nothing, no gun, nothing. So I just surrendered to the alligator coming towards me. But it wasn't coming towards me with anger. It was just coming towards me in a normal fashion. And I stood still and I just said, okay, I'm just gonna let fate take over. And so it came towards me, and actually it just stood right beside me. It didn't hurt me, it didn't attack me, it didn't try to bite me, nothing. And I was like, oh, that's interesting. I said, wow, it's not like as if the alligator was afraid of me. It's just the alligator was aligning itself with me in its own power, and I was still in my power, and I didn't run. I wasn't in fear, but I was just like, okay, you know what? I don't think I'll be able to, you know, to outwit the alligator, because of course the alligator has its own power of what it can do to me. But for me, it was like a feeling of I'm still in my power, but I surrendered. You see? So it kind of makes me feel like, wow, and I wasn't even expecting to explain it that way. It's like being in your power doesn't necessarily mean that you're taking over something, or we compare our power to one another in fear, or having fear, or bringing fear onto another person, or another person trying to exude fear onto another. And so I feel like this has to do with, you know, a part of the self-mastery is being in your own power within. And that no matter what obstacles that you may be pushing through, you know, because there's many of us that are going to be in our power, and we're going to be leading the way with others towards their self-mastery and their own healing and empowerment. And a lot of times when one is going through peeling back the layers, excuse me, of what they've had to process and to push through, you're raw and open and you feel vulnerable. And it can feel quite intimidating for others when someone else seems to be empowered and they're not. So when they are around you, there's either a fear, or sometimes there is, what's that word I'm looking for? When someone gets defensive, you know, they get defensive and stuff like that. And a lot of times some of us who are in our power, we kind of hold back and not saying something because that person might take it the wrong way, or they might think you're trying to take over their lives, or if you think you know it all and blah, blah, blah. So when you move and push through another layer of this freedom within yourself, there's also a feeling of resilience, you know. And again, I've stated before that the war that may be happening within us and outside of us, we don't need any weapons. We don't need any guns, knives, boulders, blocks, stones, or anything. You see, the power it's exudes from within you, your own inner strength, the warrior that you are from your heart. And so the alligator standing beside me, again, it reminds me of that feeling of the cohabitation that we have with one another, and even the other species of other worlds and other outer realms. That even if something may seem strange and odd, you know, that someone may have an alligator or a tiger or a lion in their backyard, it doesn't mean that that they're going to personally attack, you know, because usually anything that pulls towards you to hurt you is because of fear. You know, fear pulls these experiences towards you like a magnet. And so in this case, it's like I didn't have any fear. I was still in my power, but I let go and I surrender to whatever happens, happens, you know. I didn't feel like as if I was not going to exist anymore, but I just figured, okay, I guess if my time is up, my time is up. But in this case, my time was not up. I was still standing strong in my physical body. And not only that, I had the support of the alligator. And it's like as if the alligator was assisting me with helping other people to heal. So I'm thankful for the alligator, and I'm definitely going to be looking up now and talk about what the dream means, including alligators that are totems. You know, they are totems. Even though they're considered to be reptilian of nature, everything and all things serves its purpose. So anyway, and I couldn't tell whether it was an alligator or a crocodile. It kind of felt more like an alligator, you know. So here it says here, seeing an alligator in your dream is a reflection of your emotions towards others, which makes a lot of sense because, you know, I've been really pushing through within myself, giving birth to a new part of me that has healed so much of how I felt towards the collective, how I felt towards humanity because of who I've been in the past life and still am in, the advancement of the information I receive and what I give out, and it's a lot, you know, it's intense, and this light within me is so bright, so shining, and I've always felt like, is there anyone else that's close to where I am in consciousness? And I just felt, you know, like, for me, like, exasperating and like sometimes sad in the sense of why am I here? Because it just feels like as if everything's moving so slow in motion and a lot of times being misunderstood because of where I am in consciousness and because of where I am in awareness and how much I'm able to see through all this energy. So it makes a lot of sense to see the alligator in my dream right following after 444, you know, still in the 444 portal. And so it says here, you can become or vicious depending on how you're treated, you know, talking about as far as towards others. On a spiritual level, dreaming about alligators can symbolize the coming together of your intelligence and power. How interesting, because the channeled message that I received on April 5th in the morning, it says it has to do with tapping into and or embodying the divine intelligence. And also it has to do with not only with where you, when you become the warrior of your heart, being the warrior of your heart is where you're combining the intelligence and the love and the power together. And it shines brightly like the sun. So you might not be able to see it like when you see the sun, but you feel it in your heart. And that's where light comes through. That's where the light flows through you and your connection to the central sun and the sun. So it says here, to see a wild alligator or a crocodile in your dream foretells a new beginning or changes in your waking life, which makes a lot of sense again, because everything is reflecting new beginnings, new beginnings, new beginnings, you see? So I'm really thankful for getting this information, you know, and all of that stuff. So, I'm going to also see what else it says here to dream about. Oh, the spiritual meaning of a crocodile. Okay, so the crocodile animal totem, which is what I was looking for, serves to remind us that in life we cannot always be gentle and placid. They symbolize characteristics among the likes of courage, strength, honor, patience, speed, fear, cunning, and primal power. So when I feel into that meaning and energy, again, it reflects on the divine masculine, what the new divine masculine is, you know, because I do carry the divine masculine energy within me as well, you know, and it's like a shift in what the divine masculine energy really feels like, and then imagine what it's going to look like with those who are in the male bodies, because, you know, the divine feminine is the one that gives birth to the new divine masculine template, which also at the same time it's balanced in frequency with all the other divine masculines out there that are trying to understand how do they navigate through this. So we kind of both work together hand in hand with this. So it would make a lot of sense, you know, with the alligator coming through as a totem for the gear towards assisting the divine masculine as far as this rebirth. So it says here, the mighty creatures of land and water, alligators and crocodile animal totems are fairly terrifying, which is just how I, you know, I wasn't terrified in the dream, but I was like, oh shit, you know, like in the dream. And it says, these reptiles represent such strength, vigor, and fierceness that it's hard to imagine them being associated with anything being gentle and nurturing, symbolically, right? Which is true. It says, well, they really aren't. The crocodiles, because I wouldn't, you know, think of an alligator. It's not like as if you have a little kitty cat coming up to you and purring right next to you. You know, it has jaws that it can just crush you to pieces. You know, they'll drag you in the water and take you along deep down into the lake. And they also can be on land, you know. So isn't that interesting? The combination of that crocodiles can be and exist on land and water at the same time. You see, so it's almost like they can literally, they do become territorial, and they can literally take observance of you on both land and water, because usually before they strike you, they're already watching you from within the water, and they could be even watching you behind the bushes to be able to come and attack and to get you. So it says here, the crocodile's symbolic meaning concerns much more intense spiritual realms than most other tranquil animals. Crocodiles and alligator totems serve to remind us that in life we cannot always be gentle and placid, you know, which comes into do with that balance, you know, because usually in masculine energy, they're more, you know, told to be, you know, man up, be fierce and bold and, you know, feed into that and the anger and all of that stuff. But then it's forgotten to also be gentle and calm as well. You see, so it says here, the alligator symbolizes the likes of courage, strength, honor, patience, speed, fear, cunning, and primal power. If you've ever seen the behavior of these animals, none of these animal totem symbols should come as a shock. That does not mean, however, that they are not valuable to humans. So, symbolically, this can teach us an important lesson in observation making, seeing without being seen. In addition to their ability to hide, huh? I didn't know I was going to read this. Alligators and crocodile spirit guides represent agility and precision of motion. They hide in the reeds of the water, slowly pushing forward while hardly moving a muscle before pouncing explosively. From this, we can learn to make our decisions wisely and with care, taking time to wait for the most opportune moment to strike. So the crocodile traits are fierce, you know, which I said that yesterday from what I was channeling. Fierce. Being brave, also patience, you know, when they lie in wait in the water and they're patiently just, they could sit for hours and hours just watching their prey, P-R-E-Y, before they strike. They're fearless. They just don't care. They're going to move at any rate to whatever they want to get, and they will take their time, see? And the crocodile trait is spiritual, cunning, primal, you know, there's that primal energy that comes through from masculinity is primal. It's like, I take the lead. I'm in charge of my destiny. I know my power. You know, that's what I think of when I feel into the word primal. They're agile, precise, vigilant, angry, fake, and emotional. So that's so interesting. It's all those characteristic and traits that is defined to do with the crocodile. So The symbolic meaning of crocodile, it says that they collectively remind us of the hypervigilance that we sometimes need to exercise. Their vision is highly evolved, allowing them to see well both at night and underwater. Which is true, they can see in the dark and they can see in the light. See, just like being able to see, just like Helen Keller, when she says, I was able to see in the dark and she was able to find her light through the darkness, see? And so it's like for us to find the light through our hearts. You know, when the heart is being created from conception, before it, you know, moves into that center of becoming an embryo, everything is starting to form in the dark. Everything is starting to form through what we cannot see. And so as we're transforming our hearts, it's like we're doing it from a spiritual alchemy instead of when, you know, a mother and father is creating a child and the heart is starting to form. And the heart in and of itself is forming through an energy of consciousness that exists between both parents, you see. But also what Spirit is telling me is that they also take on the aspect of consciousness that existed from before they incarnate into the physical body. Because the soul in and of itself knows love, and it knows the endless amount of energy that comes with love from the divine side. That love that cannot be seen, but it is felt, you see? So we're actually transforming ourselves from that space, from our soul, you see? And it's being reformed into another aspect of that crystalline energy more than the density of the body. So that's the reason why it feels like it's so much happening all at once, you know, like you're fighting with and against yourself at the same time. So it says here with the crocodile, the crocodile has a highly acute sense and encourages us to develop and rely on ours as well. By utilizing their ability to camouflage themselves, they achieve major success as predators. If you find the crocodile symbolism swimming into your life, you should take it as a sign to look for an opportunity to absorb new knowledge and wisdom. These seemingly ferocious beasts signify a new beginning for growth and regeneration. As a spiritual totem, this animal contains all the unchecked creative forces of the world, encompassing the ferocity and fury of the most primal energies. You know, because the primal force energy, that's the life force itself, is so powerful and strong that if you're not in a balance with yourself, it could either destroy or create. So it takes patience and also connecting to this love that holds it together with a little more gentleness. At the same time, there's still something that will flow through you through the anger. So even though the divine masculine is going through and feeling through anger, that anger and the emotion that's raw is what pushes through into that energy of creation and love. See? So either way, the tempers, the anger, and everything in and of itself is necessary to push the divine masculine to the next level. And the divine feminine is also having to connect to their emotions, you know, because the feminine principle is where the emotions and that raw energy again is what brings in everything that is coming into creation of the self, the new self. So it says here, when you identify with the crocodile symbolism, there's a gift of surviving in a harmonious and prosperous way. Like other totems associated with water, alligators and crocodiles are connected to our emotions. Wow. The key to living in such a way is to stay in touch with your true emotions in any and all situations. It is important to be aware that what you project emotionally affects others around you. And that's key, because what had broken up on the planet, what has broken up the planet is how we have all connected to each other emotionally. And so it's like, again, we are tapping into and embodying this divine emotional intelligence as well. Okay, so you have the higher mind intelligence, you have also the emotional intelligence, the one that you're able to navigate and to take responsibility of how you respond to everything happening around you, no matter how it looks, no matter how it feels inside, and that you're able to master yourself and create another element of alchemy within yourself. You see? So it also says here, by being authentic at all times, you allow others to embrace their true selves. You know, when I say that trickling effect, these true selves may not always be the easiest or most pleasant of characters to deal with, meaning you must exercise a great deal of patience. Other people's emotions will certainly be in a chaotic state of times. Wow, didn't know this was going to be said here on this. But channeling patience and compassion will permit you to have a deeper understanding of what the person is truly trying to express. As such, crocodile spirit guides are considered to be gifted healers in the realms of emotion. Accept this responsibility and behave wisely. Dive into the emotions of yourself or others in order to seek clarity and future guidance. Whenever you are finding this task difficult, you can call upon the alligator or crocodile animal totem to assist you in grounding and settling your mind. As a spiritual totem in our dreams, the alligator and crocodile embody freedom. Wow. The unknown or hidden strength and power. However inspirational this may be, their presence in dreams can also be a forewarning of hidden danger. While this danger could be physical, it is more likely that it concerns your mind. It is possible that someone in your life is giving you bad advice or making poor decisions. Because the crocodile animal guide resides in both water and on land, they can also represent the duality of your conscious and subconscious. Both are equally relevant and influential, just as raw emotions and rational thinking are. It's what I just spoke about, the emotions and the mental space. Although it is oftentimes difficult to balance the two appropriately. Confirmation again. If something is surfacing within you, allow it, but with due caution. You may be on the brink of some new awareness or realization. Yes. Although these reptiles are not the most attractive of beasts, they definitely demand respect for their ancient beginnings. They have survived and thrived for over 50 million years with very little evolution. We must view the crocodile symbols as creatures of wisdom who have adapted to their environment and formed a solid connection with nature. When in need, we can call on them to share that profound wisdom, which can guide us toward making the best decisions in our own lives.
Because that's how much he's waiting for me.